Long back, I read a book by an English journalist who was traveling in Afghanistan. There was an Afghan person who was taking him around. So one day, his guide was telling him the law in Afghanistan, that if somebody steals, his right hand is chopped off. So he was quite shocked to hear that. He asked, for any kind of stealing? He said, yes, any stealing, right hand is chopped off. So he was expressing his surprise. Oh, how cruel it is, just for a simple little crime, the right hand is chopped off. He said, yes. And then he told him, but look, you've been in Afghanistan for so long. Did you see anybody without a right hand? Did you see anyone whose right hand has been chopped off? No. Because when the law is so strict, nobody will dare to steal. Nobody will dare to commit a crime. So that's why law and order must be maintained. Crime and punishment. They has to go hand in hand. Crime, punishment. No mercy. You committed a crime, you must be punished for that. That's why the law is there. And that's how, through the law, the order is established in the society. The famous author Alexander Dumas, he writes French novels. And there are instances when somebody committed a crime, no matter how important the person was, he was beheaded. Of course, later on, they started to take advantage of that. Unnecessarily innocent people, after the French Revolution, innocent people were guillotined, beheaded, just because they happened to have some sort of link with the royalty. After the French Revolution, they wanted to get rid of the monarchy. And if anybody had any link, blood link, with anybody in the royal family, they all were guillotined. These are all very unfortunate developments. And these things happened only recently, in the last few hundred years. Otherwise, the human society was very fair and just. No innocent was punished. On the other hand, the citizens could go and challenge the king. Like when Yudhishthir Maharaj was ruling the kingdom, one Brahmana went to him with a complaint that my son died. Why my son died before? It's your fault, king's fault. He accused Yudhishthir Maharaj that it's your fault. You are ruling the kingdom. Why such an unfair thing happened? By nature's law, I should die first and then my son in ripe old age. Why my son died young? And Yudhishthir Maharaj accepted that. He held himself responsible for that. So that is how a proper leader is. The proper leader gives protection. If there is a feeling that he had done something unfair, unjust, or something happened in his management, he would hold himself responsible.